Chennai playing Punjab in the heat of Chennai at 4 PM. Delightful game, pleasant weather.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's supposed to be a pleasant 160 degrees with 200% humidity.
And
good conditions.
Unfortunately for Chennai, no Dwayne Bravo.
Dwayne Bravo's got, a grade one hamstring tear.
Yeah.
So he's not going to be playing. How does that affect his balance? Okay, they've got a big team, right?
Yep.
But so have a look. Do you feel like they have to get some batting reinforcement, probably a Billings or a Faf, or maybe even try Murali Vijay at the top?
Their problem is yes, but they also are missing a death bowler.
Because
Bravo is their sort of death bowler. Somebody has to see Chahar they'd like to use up front.
Yeah.
So Shardul Thakur and Mohit Sharma may have to bowl a bit more. I can't see this team playing though, because you'd play one more spinner definitely if you're playing at
Bhaji probably comes in, or would you get Santana? I don't know.
Karan Sharma is there, Bhaji is there. They definitely can. They have players to bring in. And look, at some point in time, except Faf to also come into the team, because
they can get one foreigner in. They only played three in the last.
So they can probably swap Duplessis and Faf. And if they do that, then they'll probably need to swap somebody else in and bring in a spinner, to bring in, say, a Harbhajan or Karan Sharma. Either one of these guys will drop out. Either a Chahar. No, they will keep Chahar in. They'll need to drop one more spinner.
Ajay, the CSK batting. Let's talk about that for a second. They need some reinforcements.
I think they will need, because with Bravo, of course, one, he said, towards the end of the innings.
And with Watson, bowling, guy do just bowling, not really fighting.
You'll miss him for his bowling, but for his batting as well. Why they are able to play the way they play, and like how KKR plays differently with Russell coming at the back. I think the Chennai Super Kings, they, even when they lose wickets at the top, then they hold it in the middle, because they know that there is Dhoni, Bravo, Ravindra, and there's a different thing. So when you take Bravo out of there in batting, you will need much more solidity at the top. So you probably, because you only have three aircrafts on that taking off. So you have a Sam Billing, I think, works very well when the ball turns. I think he's one of the best spin players in that team. Faf, of course, did exceptionally well in the finals last year. But I think Sam Billings probably would come in there in place of Bravo, and you'll have to add another spinner.
Will they stick with both openers? There's Raidu, there's Watson. Watson doesn't bowl, so he's a batsman now.
I can't see them. See, generally the Chennai philosophy is not to tamper with something very early. So unless they really need to, they won't do it, because they believe in giving their players confidence. So they're the type who'll tell Watson, okay, Watson, Raidu, you have another three games. Don't worry about it. Just go do your thing. It'll come good.
Okay.
That's how they have always operated. I'll be surprised if it changes.
Okay, Punjab. Let's have a look at their team now. For Punjab,
the return of the prodigal. Ashwin is going to play his first IPL game in Chennai after leaving CSK.
Yeah.
Because remember, when Pune was there, Chennai was not there.
Yes, his first time in the visitors' dressing room.
Absolutely. So that will be really interesting.
Any changes you see in this, Ajay? Anything they'd like to...
It's a total different wicket that you're going to play on there. So, maybe, let me see. Mohammad Shami, Murugan Ashwin.
I see Gale coming back, definitely.
Not much change.
Do you see Gale? So, who does he play in place of then? David Miller?
If Gale's fit and he's ready, I'm sure. Especially in a low-scoring game, you want Gale in, because if he can make an impact, it just takes the game away.
So great, then who are you taking out? You'll have to take out a batsman. You can't take out Sam Curran, because you get his overs as well.
Yeah, so I think David Miller, because he's not been the flavour of this team for the last couple of years. He's been around, but in and out.
Yeah.
And he's played his part. He's done well. And left-hander, so maybe David Miller for, Chris Gayle coming in, we could see one. But with Ravichandran Ashwin also, you don't know.
Because you don't know.
He's an analyst. I mean, I think the graphic guys would probably tell us better, because he works only with the computers.
Yeah.
He works with numbers and he looks at all those things, much more importantly.
Yeah.
I'm probably the wrong guy to look at what he's going to do.
Correct. He gets his analyst and he watches a lot of video. Watches a lot of video himself, asks for video.
Do you think he watches a Cricbuzz video as well? Does he?
I'm sure he does.
So maybe put Miller in the chiller. I guess that may happen.
Miller in the chiller is a good one.
Yeah.
I mean, not a bad place to be in the chiller if you have to.
Yeah,
the other change I would definitely look at, and this is my belief, I believe Mandeep Singh is a good player, but he doesn't do enough for me as a batsman batting at 5-6, whatever the position he is at.
Yeah.
I believe, I don't know, maybe it's a form thing, I believe a batsman like Karun Nair sitting in the bench, he's a really, really good player. There must be some reason they're not playing in, but I would always, just in terms of class and ability to hit the big one, I'd back Karun Nair over Mandeep.
So there you go, that's what you're saying. You're saying put Miller in the chiller, put Nair in the fire.